Let's go, girls.
Hello, and welcome back to Feminist Cocktail Hour. I'm JC, and today we are ending our week of famous Janes with a Jane that is extremely near and dear to my heart, Dr. Jane Cooke Wright. Dr. Jane Cooke Wright was an obvious choice for me because she was instrumental in the development of chemotherapy, and this weekend marks my 3-year cancer-versary. Now, to celebrate Dr. Wright and 3 years of being cancer-free, we are going to be making a drink that I am calling a Te-Chemo sunrise. It's a riff, of course, on a classic tequila sunrise, and to make it, you're going to need some tequila, some sparkling wine, some grenadine, some orange juice, and some pineapple juice. Now, while you go wrangle all of that up, I am going to start the story of Dr. Jane Cooke Wright. William Fletcher Penn was the first African-American man to graduate from Yale Medical School. His stepson, Lewis Wright, was one of the first African-American men to graduate from Harvard Medical School. Lewis would go on to become the first African-American doctor to have a staff position at a major municipal hospital in New York City. Lewis's birth father had been born a slave and died a medical doctor. Lewis's uncle was also a doctor. So, when his daughter Jane went to Smith for art history, Lewis said, have you thought about becoming a doctor? Now, Jane was born in 1919. This is a time when even in some places metropolitan as New York City, the idea of an African-American person becoming a physician, let alone an African-American woman becoming a doctor, seemed impossible. But the Wright family liked to embrace the impossible. So Jane changed her major from art history to pre-med. She graduated from Smith and then attended New York Medical College, graduating at the top of her class in a 3-year accelerated program before becoming a resident at Bellevue Hospital. Interestingly, Jane's little sister Barbara became a hairdresser. Just kidding, guys, she became a fucking doctor. These are the Wrights. They're doctors. That's what they do. Now, Jane's father, Lewis, had founded the Cancer Research Foundation at Harlem Hospital. And Jane joined him at the Research Foundation in 1949 and became director after he passed away in the mid-1950s. During her time at the Research Institute, Jane was chiefly interested in researching chemotherapy. In fact, many call her the mother of chemotherapy. If we're going to keep talking about chemo, I am going to need a drink. So, we're going to be mixing our drink in our glass. We're going to start with 2 or 3 ice cubes, and then we are going to add 2 ounces of tequila over ice. Now, it did occur to me that calling a drink a Te-Chemo sunrise could potentially be a little bit offensive, but then I thought, I mean, I've been through chemo twice. I have done 12 rounds, so who is going to stop me? You? No, I thought not. Now, chemo, for those of you who haven't done it, is not super fun, but it is extremely important. It's also surprising how new chemotherapy actually is. Doctors just began experimenting with chemotherapy in earnest in like the 1940s. I mean, really, looking back at the history of cancer, it seems like doctors only began to understand how cancer functioned at the turn of the last century. It's only in the 1920s, actually, that case studies became a thing. So you can imagine where we're at in the 1940s. Most cancers that were non-surgical were considered fatal. Many people who suspected that they had cancer wouldn't even go to the doctors because they knew it would be a death sentence. And chemo, again, was new. It was not well publicized, it was not well tested, it was not available to many populations. Jane Cooke Wright and her father worked to change that. They wanted to make chemotherapy more accessible to patients and also, of course, more effective. Now, the OG original chemotherapy drug seems to have been basically mustard gas, which was being used during World War I and was discovered to have some efficacy in fighting off cancer cells. In the 1940s, there was a new drug, methotrexate, that was discovered as a possible new chemotherapy agent. Methotrexate is a folic acid antagonist. What the fuck does that mean? Basically, it means, I guess, that this drug stops your cells from accepting folic acid. Now, your cells need folic acid in order to produce new DNA and RNA strands. They need it to make proteins and for mitosis to happen. This is why women who are pregnant take folic acid, because they want mitosis, cell replication, to happen more frequently, because they're like building a whole new human. Cancer cells like the folic acid for the same reason. They want to proliferate as quickly as possible. So if we have a drug that is able to stop that mitosis, stop that proliferation from happening, that is a good chemotherapy drug. Now, the methotrexate had been initially used by doctors in blood cancers like leukemia, but Dr. Jane Cooke Wright took the methotrexate and tested it not just on these blood cancers, but also on solid tumor cancers like breast cancer, prostate cancer, and sarcomas. She was able to demonstrate that patients had remissions of their solid tumor cancers with the use of this drug. Methotrexate is still a commonly used chemotherapy, and in fact, is essentially the foundational drug for all modern day chemotherapy. We have the foundation of our drink, but we still need to add the fun stuff. So we're gonna add 1 ounce of orange juice. And then we're also going to add 1 ounce of pineapple juice. Guys, I love pineapple juice. Now, if you have cancer, I promise you, everyone you know will suddenly think that they are a doctor, and they will tell you all of the ways that you can cure your cancer. Maybe, like me, they will tell you, try pineapple juice, because pineapple juice is an anti-inflammatory, and that will cure your cancer. And guys, I love pineapple juice, but you know what? It didn't cure my cancer. Chemotherapy did. Now, Dr. Jane Cooke Wright did a lot of different kinds of experimentation with chemotherapy. She discovered new delivery methods that saved millions of lives. She basically was able to use a catheter system to inject the chemotherapy directly into tumors that were inaccessible through surgery. Jane was the first doctor to test chemotherapy on the cancerous tissue of a patient rather than, I guess, lab rats. Some of this is just observational. The medical stuff gets a little heady for me, but it seems like she really saw her patients as individuals, that she realized that different patients with different kinds of cancer would have varying responses to the chemotherapy. She was among the first doctors to experiment with the duration of chemotherapy and the idea of doing non-consecutive chemotherapies, but rather concurrent chemotherapies. Like when I did chemo, I didn't do like one drug at a time, I did two at once. This is what they call a chemotherapy cocktail. Speaking of cocktails, we're going to add a 1/2 ounce of grenadine to our cocktail. We're gonna pour it over the back of a spoon. This kind of a drink, a tequila sunrise, is a layered cocktail. It's about not just the taste, but also the visual. We want it to look like a beautiful sunrise. You know, like a watercolor sunrise. Guys, what if Dr. Jane Cooke Wright had kept just painting freaking watercolors? What if she'd stayed an art history major? Like, how different would the world be? It's not just the research that this doctor did, it's also like the impact she had on the medical community. She was a founding member of the American Society of Clinical Oncologists. She was the first African-American woman to be the president of the New York Cancer Society. And she served under LBJ on the President's Commission for Heart Disease, Stroke, and Cancer, driving cancer research worldwide. That doesn't even talk about the fact that, you know, she inspired and mentored many other doctors, especially African-American doctors and female doctors. It is truly impossible to calculate the impact that this woman had on medicine and the world. And yet, before today, most of you probably didn't even know her name. I'm going to throw a few other names out there. I want to throw out the name of my oncologist, Dr. Catherine Crew, her nurse practitioner, Lois Brathman. These are women who have been taking care of me for 7 years. The entire medical community right now, guys, is working overtime, which we know, but it doesn't hurt to shout them out again. You know what? I'm going to even shout out my male doctors. I have a couple surgeons, Dr. Tabak, Dr. Asherman, Dr. Horowitz, my radiation oncologist, Dr. Wynn, my radiologist. They're all incredible, and they all deserve a toast. But a proper cancer-versary toast has to have bubbles, guys. So we're going to top this cocktail with a little bit of sparkling rosé. I like that it's pink. The layered effect is gone, but now it has some breast cancer vibes. So I'm going to raise my glass in honor of all of my doctors, without whom, truly, I wouldn't be here. And of course, Jane Cooke Wright, without whom so many of us wouldn't be here. Cheers, let's try our drink. It's nice. A little fruity, sparkles good. Tastes like the beach, but also tastes like a shimmering future, like a sunrise. Guys, we made it through another week. You made it to Friday. I made it through another year. It's worth celebrating with a little musical moment. Why not? I've been doing this on Fridays. I thought I'd keep it up. So this song, I'm just going to do a little part of, was extremely popular 7 years ago when I was first diagnosed with cancer. If you're out there and you're dealing with breast cancer or, like, fuck it, just like a bad week and you need this song, it's here for you. You can be amazing, you can turn a phrase in to a weapon or a drug. You can be an outcast or be the backlash of somebody's lack of love. Or you can start speaking up. No one's gonna hurt you the way the words do as they settle beneath your skin. Trapped on the inside, no sunlight, sometimes a shadow wins. But I wonder what would happen if you say what you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, I wanna see you be brave with what you wanna say and let the words fall out. Honestly, I wanna see you. This episode of Feminist Cocktail Hour. I'm taking the weekend off, but I'll be back on Monday. I'll have another lady, another libation. Until then, cheers.
Let's go, girls.